even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved.
I'm Joe Furlow, the general manager of the Academy of Magical Arts, located here at the world-famous Magic Castle. We're known as the Mecca of Magic. Now we're going to give you a tour and let you in on a few of our secrets.
Welcome to the Academy of Magical Arts private clubhouse, the Magic Castle. My name's Armax. To go inside, you have to say the magic words. Open sesame. Come inside. Here we are at the Owl Bar. Archimedes is a psychic owl here at the castle.
Similar to Saturn, Moloch goes by many names, some including El, Baal, Baal, Dagon, and Asura. The force of Moloch is extremely wise and cunning, which is why it is symbolized as the wise owl and the knowledgeable bull. The owl you will recognize if you are familiar with the Bohemian Grove, and the bull symbolism goes way back, depicting the god as a bull or half-bull, half-man. From these symbols, you will see where they got the idea of the devil from.
Archimedes, will my shows go well tonight? Great. Archimedes, will I win the lottery tonight? All right, well then the show must go on. Here we are at the Parlor of Prestidigitation at the Magic Castle, where I'll be performing later tonight. I want to take you on a secret look backstage. Come with me. I'll give you the opportunity to see the card as it jumps. Yeah, so we'll take it forward and give it a bend so it's different from all the other cards. You can see it just like that. And I'll watch, in just a moment, it's going to jump to the top. You'll see it happen. Ready? Just like that.
People love coming into our building and spending 4 to 5 hours and kind of getting away from all of the stresses in life. It takes you back to that first magic trick you saw back when you were a kid, that bewilderment, that mind-blowing experience. And we try and do that and replicate that on a daily basis.
One of the most exclusive clubs in Los Angeles, and they have been nice enough to let us in early to show us all the ins and outs of this really great place. For starters, to get into this place, you have to enter through a trick bookshelf.
So you say to the owl, open sesame.
What do you want to do, the honors?
Open sesame.
Come on in.
Wow.
After you.
Cool. Magician and mentalist Armax Goodwin was nice enough to give us a tour.
This is the main bar, and at any given night, from let's say 5 to midnight, this place is packed with magicians and their guests, and people are here to see incredible magic in a bunch of different showrooms, have dinner, have drinks, have a good time.
Oh, did you notice everyone is dressed up? The Magic Castle has an incredibly strict dress code. I'm the kind of guy, if you see me in a suit, I'm either on my way to a funeral or court. But with the Magic Castle, they have a strict dress code, no exceptions.
So now we're going to enter the close-up gallery of the Magic Castle, which is a really unique theater. It's an intimate setting, seats only 30 people. It's a really interactive space where you can see magic really close up.
What type of magic is best for a room like this?
So I would say close-up magic, and close-up magic is defined in the magic community as magic that breaks the fourth wall.
Can I put you on the spot right now and show us a trick?
Oh, yeah, sure, of course. No.
Yes.
Normally, if you see a magician, they would say something like, pick a card, right? That's the classic thing that you're expecting. I just want you to name one.
Oh.
Any card you want.
No way. I'm already like, no way this is going to happen.
Jack of spades.
Jack of spades. Okay. And why don't you hold out a hand, palm up? Perfect. So we will use something like, all right, we have a queen here.
All right.
Queen of my card. That's okay.
We're getting there.
Start over.
Queen of Diamonds. So hold out your hand like this, Mo. Thank
you. We said Jack of Spades?
Yeah.
Okay. I already forgot.
Jack of Spades. All right. Uh-huh. So obviously you could have said something like a three, right? Watch this. That's it. It's done.
What's it?
Get the... What the hell?
Will we be able to see how you did that? Because you just filmed that. Like, if we go back, we'll see, like...
You can't see anything.
What can I do what?
You can't tell magician secrets.
No, I'm just saying we filmed it. So, like, if I'm watching the video...
Oh, like slow motion? Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to name one? Any card you'd like. 52 cards.
Do you remember the cards?
Yeah, I do remember the cards.
Don't come up with, like, Queen of Jacks or something.
Okay, actually. I'll go the... Eight of hearts.
Eight of hearts. And did you feel like that was a free choice, or did I kind of make you say that?
You didn't make me say, but I'm working hard to pick a card that I don't think you think I'm thinking.
Oh, okay. So maybe there's some reverse psychology, though.
I said eight of hearts?
Eight of hearts.
Yeah.
So the reason I'm asking is that the eight of hearts is the one card I always leave in the box.
Sorry.
What the hell? I'm like...
Don't worry, it wears off in like a week or so.
I don't know if I feel comfortable being with this guy anymore. This is weird. Like later he's just gonna be like, he's gonna, like, my watch is gonna appear in his wrist or something. Like, I'm keeping my eye on my wall for the rest. The Harry Houdini Seance Chamber.
Houdini was the best. He really defined what magic is today. And this was back in the 20s. He passed away on October 31st, 1926. And he's still known as the greatest magician of all.
Back there, we've got one of the trunks that he would escape out of.
Houdini was obsessed with seances, attempting to reach his mother in the afterlife.
We do the Houdini seance experience inside that room. It is our only private dining space that we have here at the castle. It is a very sacred room, a coveted room, so to speak.
when Houdini was famous, there was a couple other magicians who were dueling at the time, one of whom was Dante. And Houdini and Dante had a big rivalry, almost like a Hollywood rivalry, where they absolutely hated each other. And so we have another room here at the castle, part of the dining area, that's called the Dante room, right? So when there was a fire here, maybe 6 or 7 years ago, parts of the castle were absolutely destroyed, or not destroyed, but were damaged. That was the Dante room. This room, though, the Houdini seance room, was completely spared. And what's really interesting is that Houdini died on Halloween, right? And the fire happened on Halloween. So some people speculate that maybe the ghosts or, I don't know, somebody involved in Houdini's past may have spared Houdini's room, and just to spite Dante, said, yeah, let's burn that little area down.
Quick epilogue. After this, we went to the Dante room, and I had a little fun at his expense. Look at his jerk.
There he is.
Smile.
There he is.
Makes me want to set this room on fire. Anyway, later that night, we had dinner in the Dante room, and it was great. I got a little bit carried away, and when the bill came, it was like $250.
The magician Dante. He was considered the greatest magician in the world when he died in 1955. Take a look at Dante's poster ad in which a demon is holding playing cards. It also shows a demon whispering in his ear. This is a clip of one of Dante's performances. Notice that he appears in front of a large image of the devil.
There she rests. She could remain there for hours should I so desire. But watch. Margo, hear me. Are you ready? Then, go! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for your pleasure, my assistants and I will present the famous Hindu rope trick.
In this poster, notice how the demonic figure behind Dante looks just like him. You can see that there is at least one demon in all of these Dante poster ads.
It was like Dante was staring down at me as if to say, who looks like the jerk now? Me. This video is a little too anti-Dante and I feel bad about it. All right, I'm sure he's a good dude.
Yeah, who knows? Maybe he'll end up doing something to you.
Yeah, oh, yeah. The castle has several bars. My favorite is the Owl Bar, named so for the fortune-telling owl perched above.
Archimedes will answer questions of both members and guests at any time.
Guests of the Magic Castle have several magic shows to choose from, and they go pretty much all night. Small rooms, big rooms, magic at the bar, you're pretty much surrounded by amazing magic all night. The most secretive part of the Magic Castle is their library of magic. Which, of course, I was not let in.
Aww.
Sorry.
We have books in our library dating back to 1786 that show exactly how magic is done. That library is probably the best magic library in the world. The library is the one area that we'd like to continue to think of as sacred ground.
And this is the library, right?
Do you want to check the handle, see if it's unlocked?
Let's give it a shot.
Can you work magic on it?
Yeah.
No.
I think when you come here and you are amazed by our professionals that we have in here on a week-to-week basis, it takes you back to that first magic trick that you saw at whatever age it was. It was that sense of bewilderment. And I think in today's world, in today's society, we need a little bit more of that.
What's this all about?
Oh, buckshots, yeah.
This is new.
That is new, yeah. They just started selling those.
No.
Oh, it's like a little, I'll show you. Can I open? Yeah. It's just a little portable, foldable way to carry a shot. And you can open it up and use it anytime you want.
You just put a shot in the bag?
No, yeah, there's a shot inside. They store them that way. You can keep it in your wallet or, I think this one, they're all whiskey. This one's like, it's like a Dewar whiskey kind of, a whiskey blend, whiskey bourbon blend. There's something with like a, I don't know, an air.
Wait a minute. This is in here?
Yes. Yeah, well, not that one, but another one, yeah. That's what they are. There's like an air seal. This is like it sucks the thing down so that it won't break. Go for it. Don't be scared, you can drink it.
I'm not scared of drinking it. I'm just
good?
It's not bad.
And only? For a buck.
A shot for a buck?
Buckshot.
looking very nice. Magic show should be giving in a few minutes. It's going to be up on the stage. I'm going to have a blast. So let's see how good the magic show is here. And by the way, this isn't sorcery, not real magic. Magic tricks, to make it clear.
Well, hello and welcome to the Palace of Mystery. Delighted to have such an enthusiastic audience here tonight. Before we get started, a little informal poll. Find out something about you. How many have been to the Magic Castle before? Show of hands. Welcome back. Welcome back. How many here for the first time tonight? First timers. Wow, you must know someone. Yeah. How many have no idea where they are right now? Hey. Enjoy your beverage.
Wow, that was quite a show. It was about like 45 minutes. Wow. But yeah. Now I'm going to kind of take a tour of seeing what else is going on around here, including a lot of, I guess, independent magic shows going on, right?
Right.
All right, let's
get a tour next.
All right, a tour.
So hang on.
All right, let's see what else is out there. So we're going down into like a cellar right now. Don't know what to expect down here. This is where they kill people. Yikes. Torture room.
Where they kill people, yikes, torture them.
Hello, everyone. It's time to play a game.
52 possible positions. That's 52 times 52 possible options. What's that to happen next? 2,784.
So when the castle opened, that was the only show. That was the only showroom.
Yeah, oh, really?
That was
wow.
The original showroom.
I remember that.
Got it.
And this is what I was telling you about. That was the original prototype for the Haunted Mansion.
Really? Yikes. This is quite a tunnel. I feel like I'm in some sort of a ride or attraction at Disneyland or something.
Anyway, it's a game called Three Card Bind. They bend a card, they go real quick. I'll show you my version.
So when you walk around all around this castle, you're going to notice that there's various stations in which there are magicians performing magic tricks for a small group. So this is what's going on here with this some of these card tricks going on here, like a lot of the ones I used to like to buy and show my friends as well. You know, I just love the fact that it's so retro here, like time traveling back to the early 1900s, like a period piece movie. If only I had a classier suit and a fedora hat, I'd totally fit in. Okay, it looks like there's more down here. This is so elegant. Look at these lighted floors. This is quite an adventure. Now we're back into the basement. So this section down here in the basement is pretty interesting because this is where I heard that they have a lot of private parties. They would have the bar, like a bar magician, a lot of drinks going on. And they even have a library here, some museum stuff. Yes, I don't know if it's really in use right now, but yeah, it used to be jamming down here from what I heard. That's the full tour of the Magic Castle and all three of its stories. So if you happen to be here in Hollywood and you can get into the Magic Castle by invite or being a member, then please try, because it's quite a magical experience. Everything from the tour to the food to the magic show, really something.
Magic.
We could bleep this out if you don't want this on television, but your real last name has an A in it, right?
Yeah. Yeah, that's me.
You know how I did that?
Yeah.
Just like this, watch. Is that your credit card?
Man, give me that!
I just make a mental note, that's a black credit card.
God, man! You know, I changed it a couple of times, and the one I end up putting in my pocket is the one he picked. Man, it's the truth, no doubt. No lie, no tricks. He's the man. Chris, you the man. He got me.
There's like almost no liquid in here.
Oh, is it all ice?
Yeah. It's some of these things. I hate when they do that, like with the movie. Free theater. You know, they pack some up with so much ice that you don't get any. Yeah. Oh, yeah, look at this. Oh, there we go.
Oh, they got a whole salad.
Yeah, it's like a salad, exactly.
Yeah. We got some food and drinks.
Bunch of, I don't think you're supposed to eat this part, right?
Probably.
That, like goes in it to soak?
Sure, yeah. Probably should. Yeah.
Jeez.
It's like a what? It's a shared drink. Like, you're probably supposed to share it.
These are the little, like, umbrellas.
Where's the drink?
I know, that's what I'm saying. I like these little umbrellas, though. What is this? Oh, it's a shot fish.
That's dope!
I have cumin nose garnishes before. Oh! Sorry, that was really strong.
This is so great.
Oh, like pure. I think it's 151 or something.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that's good. Head. That's insane. Oh, look at that.
What? Like a little whole experience.
Yeah, it's like a dolphin catching
the.
Yeah, that's so pretty. Oh, look at that, a little rose.
It's a surprise every time.
Yeah, that's great. It's crazy.
So bad for people.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
What?
Wow.
That's
crazy.
This is killing me. I can't believe all that stuff fits in there.
Yeah, I know. I think that was the last of it.
For some tasting?
That's big tasting.
All right.
Wow.
I got frutti di mare for you.
Wow, full portion.
Here you are.
Thank
First
you.
First order of business.
Thanks.
Enjoy. My name's Johnny. I'll be around, okay?
Cool. Thanks, Johnny. All right, let's see what we got. Oh, yeah. Not a huge fan of shells. I'm going to take the shell things out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I know it's authentic, but you know, not a shell guy. All right. Oh, I can hear the shells clicking in there. Look at all that.
Oh, you got like a lot of shells.
What's that?
You got a lot. I didn't get it.
You didn't get lobster?
Nope.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I'm not gonna complain.
I got two of them. I should probably give you one of those. Let me see how many I have. Hold on.
Wow.
Yeah. A crab. Yeah, that's
it's
nice.
A whole crab.
I'm gonna use my hand if you don't mind. It's not like a shell. I don't like a lot of. Yeah, I like pieces of seafood, like shrimp or something, but not.
Yeah.
I would have that. Okay. Yeah, that's. Alright, yeah. It's underneath. I don't know how they get. A lot of shells, though. Not my. Oh, yeah. Alright, get this out. There you go, two of.
How did that even fit in the bowl?
I don't know. I think they. Well, you know. Italian pasta making is kind of a layering technique, so I think they.
Is that a squid? Yeah.
I think so, yeah. Wow. Definitely. Seaweed. If you want any of this, man, you can have some of that.
I'm good.
Yeah.
I'm good. I got some.
I feel bad you didn't get anything. Good.
That's okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you get any pasta?
It's just layered on, it's like thick underneath the pasta. It's like I gotta dig it up, you know? This. Wow. That's good. All right. Good. All right. All right. That's insane.
That's
yeah, that's a whole octopus there. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, they probably have a... Can I use your plate? Maybe to hold some of this. Yeah, just because. Yeah.
Giant tentacles.
Yeah, and feel free if you want. I mean, I don't know how I'm even supposed to eat that.
There shall not be found among you any one that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee.
חזי ו... מוטי. יהודה, בוא תעמוד כאן. יופי, עם הפנים לכולם. חולצה יפה יש לך.
תודה.
כן. אני יכול לעשות משהו עם החולצה?
בטח.
אתה תצטרך קצת להכניס רק את הבטן. טיפה. כן, אחלה. אני לוקח כאן קצה מהחולצה שלך, אוקיי? שווה הרבה החולצה הזו?
אתה צריך לקנות לי חולצה חדשה עכשיו.
בסדר. מקסימום, מקסימום. מקסימום. טוב, מוכן?
מוכן.
אתה מרשה לי?
למה לא, נו? אל תדאג, אני אקח אותו עם החולצה.
אתה הבן אדם הראשון ששרפו לו את החולצה וכל כך מאושר מזה, אני לא יודע. אתה רואה את זה?
כן.
מוכן?
כן.
זה קורה בשלוש, אבל הפוך. שלוש. שתיים, אחת. תודה רבה, תודה רבה. אני רוצה שתשימי אותה כאן, למעלה.
אוקיי.
מעולה. ותתחילי להפוך את הבקבוק. תתחילי להפוך לאט לאט. לאט לאט.
מעולה.
מצוין, נשארי ככה.
מעולה.
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 תשמחי עליי. אני רוצה שתתחילי להזיז את יד שמאל.
לא, די, די, די.
לאט לאט. תתחילי להזיז אותה. תתחילי להזיז אותה. תורידי אותה מעט למטה. תורידי אותה מעט למטה.
אמא?
אוקיי, תורידי אותה.
מיגה.
אוקיי, אל תזוזי.
זה לא אמיתי.
אל תזוזי, את יכולה להסתכל מלמטה שאין שם שום דבר.
זה לא אמיתי.
אוקיי, רגע, רגע, אל תזוזי.
זה לא אמיתי.
אל תזוזי. בואי ננסה לעשות משהו. מבנה?
לא.
אני רוצה להראות לך שאין כאן שום דבר בפנים.
אמא!
אוקיי, אין כאן שום דבר בפנים.
מיגה.
הנה, יש לנו גם את זה.
אמא לה.
אוקיי. אמא לה.
זה לא אמיתי.
תהיי מוכנה. תרכזי במים. אחד, שתיים, שלוש.
הסתכלתי עליו מלמטה, אני רואה שאין שם כלום, שזה פשוט מים, עומדים. זה לא הגיוני. זה אחד הדברים ההזויים. אין דברים כאלה.
an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee.
People ask me all the time, Jabrizi, how do you make money doing card tricks? It's quite simple. Let me show you. Check it out. Just like so. And now I got me some moolah to buy me another deck of cards. Make it rain. Thing is, when I was growing up as a kid, I didn't always have money to buy those fancy, awesome props you see at magic shops. The kits that you see. I didn't even have money to afford a magic wand. The closest things I had to that were a pencil and a pen. Let's try this. I'll take the pencil and I'll place it into my pocket. Now, if the pen is here, then that must mean that the pencil is here. Watch this. If the pencil is here, then that must mean that the pen is. Now look, I'm gonna do something real simple. I'm gonna hand you the deck and I want you to go ahead and spread it up on the window. And spread them up on the window nice and big, okay? And spread them up on the window. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. I'm gonna go inside the car. Here we go. All right. Check it out. Hands empty?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can see it, right?
The three spades, right?
Yes,
yeah,
that's the card.
How did you do it?
Check this out. So what we'll do, take your water bottle. All right, you guys come around me. Come around, closer, 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 closer. I want you guys to see this. Check it out. We're gonna tip the water bottle over. Check it out. Watch. And it freezes. But check this out, check this out. Here, I want you to go ahead, I want you to hold it. Don't squeeze it. So hold it. Stay still. I have a toothpick in my pocket. Here we go.
That's really cool.
Wait, wait, we'll do it again. Watch. One more time. Here we go. Top. Look, I'll take the cap, we'll place it on, nice and tight. There you go, man. Go ahead, check it out, examine it. Make sure that is regular old water.
That's really cool.
Lacing boxes. Have you seen those?
Where it's like the laces actually like to carry the box?
Yeah. Oh, those little holes that go in the sides.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah. The company rep showed us. It's like you slide the, you pull it through just about to there. Yeah. And it's just a matter of how much, you
just
know,
to actually lace the shoe. That's crazy. I didn't.
Yeah. It goes in like this, and it systematically pulls it. If you lay the shoe in the bottom like that, you just kind of shake it.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and then, yeah, it laces it up.
No way. No way.
Yeah.
So here. Hey, did you just lay the laces, like, in, how did you put them in there? Like, how did that just happen? I didn't.
So those are not made in gold?
They're not made in gold.
I see.
No, that's something we have to do.
Okay, you and know? How long will that take?
I'm doing it.
Oh, let's do it.
Yeah, they make this stuff.
So you do like, spray on it, or?
Yeah, it's like a spray.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You haven't seen this before?
I have not.
Oh, yeah.
Usually, if I order gold glasses, they just,
well, they come not in. Every company, because there's so many options nowadays, uh-huh. Like every company can't make every single frame in
okay.
Every single option.
I see.
So this is a really great
and
product.
That doesn't affect the skin in any way if you have sensitive skin? I mean,
well,
it dries, of course.
I get a little sting when I do it.
Oh, okay.
But it's not, it doesn't tint it. It actually changes the molecular structure of the metal.
Oh my God.
Isn't that wild?
It is.
this was made on accident. This
I'm still curious as to how it treats the skin over time.
It's funny you said that because I always, after I do something in gold, I don't like to touch like a lot of stuff. I'll always grab like one more thing just in case that it's gonna be okay because it's still like on the pads of my fingers. Yeah, so I'll just like rub something.
Yeah,
so it just leaves a little bit on there, so I'll do like one more thing that I want.
Oh, you use that for this pen too?
Yeah.
You just did it.
Yeah.
This pen was black.
Yeah. I always do one more thing so that it like comes off completely from my hands.
I wonder. There is no more black.
Yeah.
Hi. What's your name? Okay, let me try again. Well, welcome to America's Got Talent anyway.
Died in a building
blaze. Suicide victim to blame.
Oh my gosh.
Yes?
Who caused the fire?
Choose a name. I said Bob. Suicide victim to blame.
Oh my God. This is Bob.
Bob. My hands are shaking. And what's under the Polaroid? Don't even ask. I just guessed a random name. I'm turning this over.
Look.
Oh my God! Bob is behind me!
Look at that. That is, you should go away. Go away now.
That's crazy.
even him, whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness.